Testing. Let's see, do I? Yeah, it's just, all right, okay.
All right.
So for the second week of October, the homeworks are all the same, the kind of questions that we're doing. So I'm just going to go off on today's homework, this week's homework, and the kind of questions you're going to have. So in this week, you are going to solve three kinds of trapezoid area problems, and I'm going to go over one of each. All right, so if you have a question, then, all right. So first I'm gonna start with the most basic. If you have a question, you should rewatch this. That's what I meant to say. Now, I'm also gonna make the exception because usually in the old curriculum, we start off with decimals first before we do geometry. So for those of you who are struggling with decimals, I'm gonna let you use a calculator for now, all right? Because we are going to cover decimals later on in the year. So right now, even if you use a calculator, it's not the worst thing, especially just for homework, okay? So let's see. Now, here we have a trapezoid. So what's the area formula for a trapezoid? Do you guys remember? All right, let me see if I can find a pen. All right. So what's the area formula for a trapezoid? Yep, base one plus base 2, take the whole thing, that's a b, right? Multiply by the height, and then divide it by 2, right? So, now let me see if I can make the pen thinner. I don't think I can. Nope. Okay, all right, let's go with this for now. Now, here, where's base 1? It's right here. Where's the base 2, right? So here, I'm going to add them first. So I'm going to write the formula down for every question. And then I'm going to do base 1, 5.3, plus the base 2, which is 13.1. I'm going to just fill in the whole formula, okay? Where's the height? Right here, 5.2, right? And then when I'm done with the whole thing, I will divide it by 2. Okay? All right, so now I don't need a calculator for this, so I'm just going to do this in my mind. So 3 plus 1 is 4, so the answer is something 0.4. 5 plus 13 is 18. Multiply that by the height. What did I write here? Oh, 5.2. Okay, all right. Right? And so let's see. What's 18? So let me get my calculator and do 18.4 times 5.2. And that will be 95.68. So having a calculator definitely helped. And I'm going to take that whole thing in the calculator. So if you can see this, I can just leave the answer like this, press divide. You see how it says just the answer, right? I can take the answer and just divide it by 2, like this, right? I press enter and I got 47.84 centimeters squared. So I'm gonna go back to the cursor, 47.84, submit the answer, that's it. Okay. All right. Now, I'm going to show you a different kind of question. So let me clear the screen first. How do I clear the screen? Okay, maybe I can't. Okay, this is new, the way they're doing this. So it's confusing me, actually. Okay. All right. Onward. So now I want to show you a different second type of trapezoid, which is called right trapezoid. Right. So this, what you see here, is also a trapezoid. That is great. Okay, let me see if I can. Hold on. Let me press pause and try to clear the screen real quick. Okay, all right, I'm back. All right, so now let's take a look at this. All right, so again, one more time, we're going to write the area formula out for a trapezoid. Base 1 plus base 2 times height divided by 2. Now, this is base 1, right? That's the top base. Second base, so here I'm going to do 7.1 plus 13, multiply by 4.6, and then divide the whole thing by 2. Now, here 7.1 plus 13, what's that? Yep, 20.1 times 4.6, and then the whole thing divided by 2. All right, pardon my handwriting. Now, again, I'm going to go to my trusty calculator, do 20.1 times 4.6. That's 92.46. And then divided by 2, all right, so divided by 2 in the calculator is 46.23. So I'll just write it in. Oh, let's see, 46.23, I hope I'm right, it should be right, and we're good. Okay, so one last one. So let me clear the screen. Oh, look at that animation. That's kind of cool. You see that? All right, so you can't miss it. All right, you should be able to do this. Okay, last one. This is called right trapezoid, isosceles. Okay, this one, it's turned upside down, okay? Still a trapezoid, right? Even if it's upside down. Now, here's the thing. There's a little extra step here. I don't know if you can see this. So here, I have this one base as a whole thing. So it's separated. So this is one base, okay? So this is base one, base two. Doesn't really matter, right? So we have to add these two first. Okay, so that's 15.2 plus 10, so that's 25.2, right? So the height is this, right? So, okay, let's write it out, right? Base 1 plus base 2 times the height, which is 7.5, and then the whole thing divided by 2, right? So, okay, let's see. Now, here I got 9.2 plus 29, so that's 0.4. So that's 9, so 9 plus 25 is 34, right? So that's 34.4 times 7.5. And then I take my answer divided by 2. So it's 34.4 times 7.5, right? Yep, 258. Okay, nice round number. Divided by 2, 129. So let me enter that in. So here, I've shown you all three types of trapezoid questions you need to know for the week. So anytime on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, if you have issues with doing this homework, you can always come back to this video, okay? There's also here, I don't know if you've seen this, right here, I'm gonna click on this. Delta Math has their own help videos. So anytime you run into trouble, all right, you can also click that and they'll show you how to do it too, okay? So that's nice. All right, so I'm gonna sign off here. Thanks for watching, and okay, I will see you next week then, all right? Okay, bye now.
OMG, that was so good.